Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1823A, why you should never use equal B1 plus B2 plus B3 plus B4 plus B5. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jell, and today's question is sent in by Crispin. No, I'm kidding. Hey, this is great. I ran across a blog post by David Yanofsky yesterday, writing at QZ.com. So that's from November 5th. I'll put the link in the YouTube description right down there. But check this out. So David works in New York, and he was down in the Spring Street subway station and saw the print ad. This is not just a laptop. This is not just a tablet. This is the new Surface, right? Nice ad. That's great. I guess it's all over the subway and bus stops. But David took a closer look. Now, this happens to me sometimes on my Power Excel seminars, especially if I'm in front of a room full of auditors. They'll actually check the math in my spreadsheets. And David looked at this 2,500 plus 4,000 plus 500 plus 15. That adds up to 9,500, and the total in the spreadsheet is 9,000. Oh, this is so bad, right? Excel has a bad reputation for spreadsheet errors, and here now an official Microsoft ad is showing an obvious spreadsheet error. How bad is that? But then I started to think, how could the ad agency have screwed this up? What steps could they have possibly gone through that Excel wouldn't get the total right? So here's the original numbers. It's off by 500, which either means they added car, which seems unlikely because that is an obvious travel expense, or dive rentals, or they added the last two in order to get more color in the pie. So let's assume that they did that, even if they would have done auto sum, right? So use the auto sum function, and even let's say that they explicitly chose just those five. Excel can deal with this. If we insert two rows, and let's see, it's surf rentals here, and other excursions here. I'm going back to Excel 2003, provided you have a series of three or more numbers, they're going to change the formula. They're going to rewrite the formula to handle that. So the formula there just changed to include B6, and then I type in 300 here, and the formula changes to include B7. So how could the ad agency screw this up? All right, let's go back. I'm going to undo. One obvious theory is they don't know how to add at all, and they just simply put 9,000 in there. That would do it. The other thing that's possible is they built the formula like this, equal B1 plus B2 plus B3 plus B4 plus B5, right? And you get the right answer. Sure, I remember back in 1985 using Lotus 1-2-3, I did the same thing, and then someone came along, one of the graduate students at Notre Dame, and said, hey, no, you have to use at sum. I'm like, well, no, this works. And they said, no, use at sum. And the reason you want to use equal sum in Excel instead of this is for this very problem. So you come along, and let's even add it in the middle, right? Surf rentals of 200. Ah, see, the total doesn't change. And then here, we'll add at the end, other excursions. Total is not changing. So either they just type the number there, or they use this really bad method of creating the formula, which sure gave you the right answer from the beginning, but then doesn't work after that. You know, then the other thing that got me, I started to look at this chart. Was this chart created in Excel 2013? So I'm going to create a chart. If they would have used recommended charts, it would have suggested the clustered bar chart, not the pie chart. But okay, let's say that they chose the pie chart, and then triple click the title, Hawaii budget. Made the chart a little bit less wide. All right, so we're starting to get there. We have the legend that matches Hawaii budget. We'll probably need to increase the size there a little bit. All right, that's starting to look good, but this chart still doesn't look like that chart. First off, the colors for the last three slices are different. So I said, hey, that's cool. Whoever did this might have known about the chart styles and the new color swatches available out here, but none of these colors match the ones in the ad. Okay, well, maybe they've been around Excel since Excel 2007, and they know the colors palette back here on the page layout. There's 40 different colors, and I ran through all 40 of those, and none of those match. Median gets sort of close, but still, they had to change the one or two of those in Photoshop. Okay, but then, even then, what's up with these big white gaps between the columns. Is that an exploded pie? It's not even in the chart anymore. If you would go to Chart Design, change chart type, they don't offer exploded pies. Of course, we can still get there using Control 1 or select the series Control 1 and then pie explosion, but I tried various pie explosions and none of them really match what's shown in the ad. They kind of get too gappy and move out from the center, so it's not a pie explosion. So what did they do? How did that ad come about with those big gaps? And then I realized what they must have done is selected the series, come back here to shape outline, chosen white as the shape outline, and then still beyond that, they would have to go in and change the weight. Let's try 3 point. That starts to get really close, all right? That's an impressive set of steps to click here, then back on Format, Shape Outline, change to white, and then weight, and find the right weight to get those gaps there in the chart. It's really kind of amazing that they knew that, but not how to total. All right, hey, again, go out to QZ.com, check out this article by David. Follow him on Twitter, visualization guy, lots of great things. Hat tip to David for noticing this in the subway and actually taking up the time to notice that the numbers don't foot. What an embarrassing thing. We finally have Excel and an ad, and Microsoft shoots itself in the foot with a spreadsheet error plastered all over the New York City subway. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.